you can win this beautiful car on the turn of a single card on Card Shark. And if you play your cards right, you can win $32,000. And now, the host of Card Shark, Bob Eubanks.
Oh, thank you. Good morning, everybody, and welcome to Card Shark. Hey, when we left off last time, we just crowned a new champion. He's a nice man, and I want you to meet him right now. So let's get him in here. Come on, Dave. This is our new champion, our card show. Hello, Dave.
Hi.
You happy?
Happy, yes.
Happy. The man from Virginia is going to try to win some money. What part of Virginia now?
I'm from Galax, Virginia.
Where's Galax?
Well, it's in southwest Virginia. I'm a minister there, and I have two grandchildren.
No.
Yes.
How old are you?
Old enough.
Yeah. Me too, darn it. Want to compare pictures? No, we won't do that right now. Listen, let me tell you what's about to happen to you, because now we're going to give you a chance to win a whole lot of money, and let's get our two lovely dealers in here right now. They are Lacey Pemberton and Susanna Williams, our dealers on Card Shark. Now, Dave, in addition to all the money you can win, we've got a new car to give away, too. And what we've done is we've added a couple of jokers to the deck over there, the deck that you cut earlier. Every time a joker pops up, it gives you another opportunity of winning that new car. I want you to keep in mind you can change one card per line. That's very important to you. And because you won the two games and you're our champ, well, Lacey's got one joker for you, so you know at least have one chance of winning that car. Get him, guy. We're going to give you some $200 to bet with. Can we do that, please? All right. There we go, Dave. We're on our way now, David. First card happens to be a 9. You can play or change it, Dave.
$50 lower.
Going to keep the 9 then.
Keep
okay,
the 9.
$50 lower than the 9. No, it's all right. $150. Play or change the 10.
Okay, I want to change that card with number 1.
Number 1. Let's see what we got. 10 will now be a 5. You got $150.
$100 higher.
$100 higher than the 5. Oh, back to 50. That's all right.
All of it higher.
Yeah, we're going to go higher and win some money now. There we go. Lousy cards. Got 100 up here. I'll give you another 4. You got $500 now. What are you going to do with this 10?
I'm going to keep the 10 and go $100 lower.
$100 lower than the 10. There we go. 600.
All of it higher.
Yeah, step up and meet him. Here we go. All of it higher than the 3. Push. No win, no loss. You're all right. Still got 600.
Same bet, higher.
All of it. Going all of it higher than the 3. Yeah. Now, my friend, you got a chance to make some money.
All of it lower.
Yeah, it's going to be worth $2,400 for you. Is it lower? It certainly is. There you go.
Thank you.
Wow, it's nice car.
It was.
You did good. You got now a total of $2,600 in cash. And we're not done yet. Lacey, thank you, Lacey. Lacey's got a joker for you. I want you to take a look over here for me, Dave, because we have 7 numbered cards. Behind one of them is the word car. If you find it, well, Gene's going to tell you about the car you can win. Gene?
The Buick Skyhawk Coupe. The sports car with room and comfort equipped with standard features, plus pinstripes and California emissions. Good luck, David.
All right, Dave, that's the car you can win. All you have to do is go find the car.
Okay.
Know where you're going?
You know where I'm going.
All right, go put it over there. Must have 2 grandchildren, is that it?
Yes.
Yeah, that's why you picked 2, right? Come over here. Heck, I'd have to pick 14. Only kidding. If the word car is behind number 2, then you are the big winner of that new car. We're rooting for you, guys. Is it there? Yeah! Now has won $12,015 in cash and prizes, and we'll be back in just a moment to meet a new challenger. Play more Card Shark right after this. Way to go, man.
I said if I made it, I was going to.
Welcome back to Card Shark. All right, champ. That's wonderful. Did you really pick 2 because you have 2 grandchildren?
Yes.
All right. It worked. Boy, look what would happen if you'd had 3. You wouldn't want a car.
I know.
Yeah, I know. Well, let's not think about those bad things. All right, let's bring in a new challenger. Come on, Christy. Join us on Card Shark. How are you, sweetie?
Hi, Bob. How you doing?
Well, I'm doing just fine. Tell me about yourself.
I'm Christina Carter. I'm originally from Ohio. I now live in Riverside, California. I work for a utility company. I'm 32, and I am single.
Does that mean you're looking?
Always.
You're always looking?
Always.
Well, let me see what we can find for you. Huh, I don't know. We got a guy on our show named Sid. I don't know if he's available. Well, he's too old for you. I'll tell you what let's do. Let's start off right now. If you win two games, you are a champ. That's all you have to remember. And Dave, the first question goes to you. And this question involves 10 women who are married to men 10 years younger than themselves. They'll be with us all week. And there they are. These are 10 women who are married to men 10 years younger than themselves. And so here's your first question, Dave. Before the show, we ask our 10 women, are you at least 20 years older than your husband? We know they're all 10 years older, but are you at least 20 years older? How many of these 10 women are at least 20 years older than their husband, Dave?
Well, Bob, I don't know for sure, but I do know that my wife is a little bit older than I am, but 20 years is a lot of span of difference, so I think that's going to be a low number. I'm going to say two.
Two of them, you might. Okay, Christina, will be higher or lower than two, huh?
I think he's pretty right on. I'm going to go for three.
So you're going to say what, higher or lower?
Higher, I'm sorry.
Higher, that's okay. I figured out that three is higher than two, but I wanted her to say it. I mean, I just didn't parachute in. The actual number of these women who are at least 20 years older than their husband is one. No, it wasn't higher, it was a little bit lower. Only one. Which one of you ladies married a guy 20 years your junior? Raise your hand if you would, please. Margaret, you devil, you. All right, Margaret. And Margaret, let's see, you were 30 years old when you married this guy?
I was 30?
No, I'm just teasing you, Margaret.
No.
How old are you, Margaret?
How old am I?
Yeah.
I'm 63.
63?
Yes.
And
my husband is 22.
Your husband's 22? Way to go, Margaret! Now, how many times have you been married, Margaret?
Four.
Four times?
Yes.
Is this the first time you married a younger guy?
No, they've all been younger.
They've all been younger? Oh. Well, how about that? Thank you, ladies. It's going to be fun having you with us. Okay. Who has all this control? Dave does. Dave. Here's your card, Dave. It's a seven. You want to change that?
Change that card.
Well,
yes.
Heck yes. The seven will now become a nine.
Lower, Bob.
Lower than the nine, is it? Oh, yes, it is.
Higher, Bob.
Higher than a six. Got a nine for you.
Freeze.
Yeah, we'll freeze right there. That keeps Christina away from the cards. We'll see if your strategy works, because I now have a question for Christina. Christina, we surveyed 116-year-old girls. We asked them, would you rather sit home alone on a Saturday night than be seen out with your parents? How many 16-year-old girls did rather just sit home alone?
Oh, when I was 16, I would rather sit home alone. It was kind of embarrassing to go out with mom and dad. You see your friends somewhere, and they'd be out having a good time, and here you are trying to hide away, and I think they're kind of embarrassed to be with their parents at that age. They'd rather be out having fun with the kids their age. So I'm going to say that's a high number.
I was embarrassed to be seen with my parents. My parents always went to burlesque houses, you see. Wait till my mother sees that. Oh, she'll die. I mean, she'll die. Okay, so how many do you say would rather sit home alone?
I think a lot of them will. I'll say 57.
57 out of 100 would rather sit home alone. What do you think, David?
Well, Bob, I have a teenage daughter, and I know that she had much rather stay home than to be seen out with us, especially on a weekend night. So I'm going to say that number's even higher.
Yeah, but she'll try to borrow that new car. You wait and see.
Oh, her. Yes.
Actual number of 16-year-old girls who'd rather sit home alone on Saturday night than be seen with their parents is 24 of them. No, it wasn't higher, it was lower. All right, Christina, you got to play the cards now, and there's your card. You want to change that?
I'm going to change that, Bob.
There you go. Okay, the nine will now become a five.
There you go, higher.
Higher than the five? Let's see. Yeah.
Higher, Bob. Higher. We're going higher.
Didn't know what she's going to do. Is it higher than
higher.
The nine? Be there, be there. If it is there, you win the game. You do. Whoa! Well, there's $100 for you. Most importantly, the first game. That means if you win the next game, you're the champ. Dave's going to try to keep that from happening, and we'll set up for game number two. Be right back for that. Right after this.
Buzzer. Our banking with Chime today at Chime.com.
Welcome back to Card Shark. Well, shall we start game number two? Dave, pressure's on you now. See?
No problem.
No problem. Okay. First question goes to you. It's an educated guess question. You ready for this? Play along with this at home. You'll have a good time with this one. Tell me. This one's going to make you a little bit ill, too, folks. How much does it cost taxpayers to provide Secret Service protection for a presidential candidate for one day? How much does it cost taxpayers?
Well, Bob, I read an article on that not too long ago, and I think it's about $75,000 a day.
$75,000 a day. Christina, higher or lower than that?
I think it's going to be a high number, but $75,000 is a lot of money. I think it's got to be lower than that.
Think it might be lower?
Yeah.
Man, how many are running for the Democratic side? 8? And how many in the Republican side? 5 or 6? This is going to make you real sick,
You're
folks.
You're not making me feel good, Bob.
Oh, don't worry about a thing, folks. The actual cost for the Secret Service to protect a presidential candidate for one day is $15,000.
Yes.
But still, that's a lot of money. And it was lower. Christina, you're right. Okay, here we go. Are you ready? There's a card. 7.
I don't like that 7. I want to get rid of it. Change it.
Well, you've come to the right place. We can change it.
Good.
7 now becomes a queen.
Lower.
Lower than the queen. How about a 6? Gonna go higher than the 6. Is it? Certainly.
Oh. Freeze!
She's gonna freeze right there. Okay. Made David mad when you froze there. Next question. Christina? Surveyed 100 ministers. Step up, Reverend. We surveyed 100 ministers and we asked them, when people find out what you do for a living, do they start treating you differently? How many ministers said that when people find out what they do for a living, they treat them differently?
Yes, I think a lot of people do. I remember having a conversation with a gentleman at one time, and I didn't know he was a minister, and we were telling jokes. And by the punchline, I could tell his face was getting kind of light and pale. And
yeah.
Well, I found out he was a minister, and I never told him the punchline.
He probably
of
the
knew joke.
The joke anyway. So how many do you think?
It's going to be high. Let's go with 62.
62 out of 100 say they treat the man differently when they find out he's a minister. Well, let's check with the minister. David?
Well, Bob, personally speaking, I think sometimes they do treat you a little bit different.
Did you hear the one about... Oh, no, never mind.
I think that's going to be just a little bit lower.
Might be lower?
Yes.
All right, let's see. Actual number of ministers who said that when people find out what they do for a living, they treat them differently is 93. I thought you'd get that one right. 93. Christina.
I'm going to get rid of that 9.
Okay, Lacey's got a new one for you. The 9 becomes a 4.
Higher, Bob, higher.
Higher than the 4? No.
Tough luck.
Tough luck, he says, yeah. Bless you, my child. Tough luck. Now, let's get to the cards, quick. All right, David, free chance. There's a 4.
Higher, Bob.
Higher than a 4. Nope. Tell him, Christina.
Tough luck.
Tough luck, right? Next question. Let's ask a question that David knows something about. Dave, 79-year-old Betty Davis recently appeared on a TV talk show wearing a short skirt. So we surveyed 100 men, and we asked them, if an older woman has good legs, is it okay for her to wear a revealing skirt? How many men said it's okay?
Well, I think most men, Bob, like to look at a pretty pair of legs. And
does that include you?
Yes.
All right.
So I think that's going to be a relatively middle number. I'm going to say about 53.
50. You may have a new car, but your congregation is going to be gone when you get home. You know that. 53 out of 100. Christina, higher or lower than that?
I think men love to look at a good pair of legs, regardless of how old the woman is. And if she's older, they might even appreciate them better. So I'm going to say it's higher.
Might be higher. The actual number of men who said it's okay for an older woman to wear a revealing skirt is 81 of them. Yes, it was higher. All right, now, Christina.
Let's go for it, Bob, and go higher.
Higher than the 4. Tell her, Dave.
I'm sorry.
Yeah, thank you. Dave, free chance.
Higher.
Higher than the 4, yeah.
Lower, Bob.
Lower.
Oh. Tough luck, Dave.
Tough luck. We're going to pause for these words. We'll be back with Sudden Death. Don't go away. We'll be right back, guys.
We sat down. Bites.com.
Welcome back to Card Source. We're going to play Sudden Death now to find out who's going to win this game. If it's Christina, she's our new champ. If it's Dave, we'll play tiebreaker game. So remember, control is what you're looking for. Someone must win the game on the next play of the cards. And Christina, this is your question. This question involves 10 women who are married to men at least 10 years younger than themselves. And there they are. Now, Christina, before the show, we ask these 10 women, when you met your husband, were you actively looking for a younger man? How many of these 10 women were actively looking for a younger man?
I think they were actively looking. I think you either know whether or not you're attracted to younger men or older men.
Are you looking for a younger man?
Definitely.
I'm sorry, Sydney.
Always have been.
Yeah.
I'm going to say 4.
4 out of the 10 were actively looking for a younger man. David, what do you think?
I think that's going to be higher, Bob, because I agree that when you know what you're looking for.
Is that right?
Yes.
Did you know what you were looking for when you found your wife?
Yes.
And you got her?
Right.
Way to go, big guy. Actual number of these 10 women who are actively looking for a younger man is 1. Only 1.
Margaret.
Yeah. I wonder which one it was. Oh, it's you, Darlene. Oh, I'll be darned. You were you just went out looking for a young guy.
Oh, I most certainly did.
Why?
I was widowed very young,
uh-huh.
And I had dated older men, and they were so serious, and they talked about the money they made, and they talked about their success, and I got so tired of it.
Sure.
That when a girlfriend called me and said, let's go to a singles bar, I said, great, I'll meet somebody younger.
What do young guys talk about?
That's what I did.
What do young guys talk about?
Younger men are a lot more fun. They're not talking about such serious things as business and all of those things that I didn't want to hear.
What do they talk about?
Well, they talk about...
Thank you, ladies. Nice to have you with us, okay? We're playing Sudden Death. Who's got all this control? Christina? Christina, you got a couple choices here. You can play it out. If you goof, he wins the game, or pass it on to David. He must play off the 4. If he goofs, you win the game and the match.
It's all yours, David.
Thank you.
Here we go, Dave. All up to you, pal.
Higher.
Higher it is.
Higher.
Higher to 5. No! We've got a new champ, it's Christina.
Congratulations.
Oh, thank you.
Well, Dave, you leave us, but with $12,015 cash and prizes, including that brand new car. You're a nice man. Thank you for being
here. Thank
with
you, Bob.
We'll see you again. Bye-bye. Christina, right over here, my dear. All right, this is our new champ. In just a moment, we're going to give her a chance to win a lot of money and a new car. We'll see if she can do it right after this.
That's tackle.
Welcome back to Card Sharks. Our champion's Christina now. Christina, the ladies have the cards dealt out. There's a couple of jokers over there. When they pop up, that gives you a chance of winning that new car. Lacey's got one joker for you, so you know at least have one opportunity. Remember, you can change one card per line. So let's give her $200, and let's see what happens. Here we go. All right, Christina. First card happens to be a 10. You can play or change.
I'm going to play, and I'm going to go $50
lower. $50
lower
than the 10. Is it lower? It certainly is. $250.
Change that one with number 3.
Number 3. See what the 8 becomes. Susanna's got a new one for you. The 8 is now a 5. And you got $250.
I'm going $200
higher. $200
higher
than the 5. No. Whoa.
It's okay. We're going all of it higher.
Time to build again. Higher than the deuce is a 7. You got 100 up here. I'll give you 4. You got $500 now.
I'm going to change that card with number 1.
Number 1. All right. 7 will be a 5.
Okay, I'm going $450 higher.
Woo, $450 higher
I
than the 5.
Play.
Here we go. Yeah. $950.
And $100
lower than the queen. Push, no win, no loss. Scared
We're doing
you to death.
It again, $900
lower. $900 lower than the queen. You got
yes.
it again. $1,850. I assume you want to change the 10.
I'm going to change it.
Yeah, I don't blame you. Why not? 10 becomes a 6. And now, you've got $1,850. You got to bet at least $925.
We're going $1,500 higher.
We are?
Yeah.
Don't include me in this because I get real nervous. Okay, $1,500 higher than the 6.
Be there
for the lady, yeah! There it is! Now you've got $3,350 in cash, and we're going to give you a chance of winning a new car right now. Lacey's got a joker for you. Take a look over here now. As you probably know, 7 numbered cards. Behind one of them is the word car. Okay, Christina, go get it. Number six, the lady said. We've already given away one car today. We'd love to give another one away. Let's see if the word car is behind number six. If it is there, you win the car. Behind number six is the word... No. But let me tell you how close you were. It was behind number seven. No car, but that's okay. You're our champ, and that means that when we meet next time, we'll meet a new challenger. And our champion has won $3,550 for Susanna Williams, Lacey Pemberton, Gene Wood, and the gang. I'm Bob Eubanks. We'll see you next time on Card Sharks. Bye-bye, everybody.
Some of our departing contestants will receive Pond's Cold Cream Deep Cleans, lifting away dirt and makeup that soap leaves behind. Pond's Deep Cleans better than soap. Genuine Vaseline Petroleum Jelly heals, soothes, and protects rough, dry skin. Why trust your skin to anything less? It's no surprise. Spencer's has always manufactured American-made quality infants and children's basics, sleepwear, and sportswear. A generous supply of Kentucky Fried Chicken. It's tender and juicy, bite after bite. At Kentucky Fried Chicken, we do chicken right. Eureka's Quick Up, great four between cleaning cleanups, lightweight, rechargeable, cordless, and in-betweening vacuum Eureka. Sun-made fruit bits, a delicious snack with natural goodness of real fruit. Enjoy a tempting fruit snack from Sun-made. And the member of our studio audience will receive Magnavox Video Escort, a compact, fully automatic camcorder with a high-speed shutter to capture past action and play it back instantly from Magnavox. Gene Wood speaking for Cut Sharks, a Mark Goodson television production.